first Lamborghini to use turbocharging and the first to have an automatic gearbox.
Means that actually, it's not that safe at all.
There's no manual locking differentials, there's no low-range gearbox. All you can do is fire it up and then put the drive system into slow mode. Carefully.
It's right at the moment where excitement stops and terror begins. I had a few practice laps on my own.
Is this quite scary thing here?
As far up a ski slope as a Range Rover, but
For doing this, it's better.
Now we'd find out what's what on our specially designed trip.
To make this car, Lambo's engineers had a good run in post-box, hard spoke. So the engine, a full V8, is from the rear axle and air suspension is from a Bentley. The platform on which it sits and a lot of the dashboard is from the S2-7. So there's no reason. This is a really good vehicle at all. Now we go on to the really fast bit.
It wasn't just fast on the straights, but quicker through the corners too. And in the 1963 season, Clark used it to win a record 7 out of the 10 Grand Prix, such as Cortina and racking up touring car victories.
We're off.
going!
Oh, I'm slightly alarmed.
And on top of all that, there was America. Upstart from across the pond, take a rookie driving test before he could compete.
Power, this is good.
Come Indy weekend, the upstart from across the pond.
Because he was just so precise.
Go, go, go!